champion of the world. He's kind of full of surprises. I'm not sure that I understand Muhammad Ali all the time, or that anybody does. Last time he was on the show, he walked on one night, unannounced, because I had made some jokes in the monologue the night before about the fight. Not bad jokes, just in jest. But he is with us tonight. Would you welcome the champ, Muhammad Ali?
I heard that little joke you were saying. You know, when you first came out, you opened the show talking about me.
Yeah.
You real nice. You real nice with a joke. But how are you with a left hook?
This is where it ends, right here. Left hook's pretty bad. You know,
We could go today.
I did fight when I was in the service.
You boxed?
Yeah.
What you box? Oranges, bananas, grapes.
I don't know what I'm going to do with that. 1 week ago tonight, was it?
I was in my dressing room, shitting, real nervous. Just
real nervous?
Yeah, man.
What were you nervous about?
The fight.
I thought you didn't get nervous for a fight.
What you talking about, man? I'm nervous.
Now, come on, be honest.
Man, you know, good and well, the way I talk, if I lose, I'd have to leave the country. I can't afford to lose, man. Enough now, I'm winning.
Yeah. A lot of the, hey, you look great tonight. You didn't have to dress this way, you know.
Yeah, one of these nice after six suits.
Yeah.
I had it.
You get it just for the show?
No, yes, for your show. But first, for the Ebony magazine, they had the 20th anniversary of the Waldorf Astoria today. A lot of the great entertainers and senators and the White House was there, and I had to be sharp, you know.
Yeah. You were taking it. When you dropped in my dressing room tonight, you were taking the trousers in on the side.
Don't you have to tell everybody that.
Would you get a bad fit?
I know, but when I had the suit made, I was 25 pounds heavier than I am now. And the waist was too big, so I had to buy a safety pin to pin the thing up.
Well, it's all right. You didn't mind my messing that, did you?
No, but you know, man, that's some world champion with a safety pin in his hand.
That just makes you one of the people. Now, be honest with me. Were you nervous before that fight, or were you so confident?
I was nervous, John. I was scared to death. Main thing, I was so afraid that it might end in one round. And it plagued me so until I didn't full punch the first round. Just to get that out of my head.
You didn't throw one punch?
I didn't throw one punch the first round.
Were you just feeling him out, or?
Well, I got to the fight a little late, and I didn't have time to warm up in the dressing room. So I had to rush right there.
What were you doing in the meantime?
I had to warm up about 10 minutes. I didn't have time to, warm up, because I had so many fans of mine that didn't have tickets, and I had to push them into the back door, and I had to go buy tickets and, try to get my friends in.
Had you ever been to Las Vegas before?
I was there once. I fought a big giant there named Duke Sabadon about 3 years ago.
Is that a good place to fight?
Yeah, it's a nice, nice fight town, Johnny, as far as because a lot of money is there, and that's the main thing. The people can afford to pay to fill up the ringside seats, and it's real nice. It's for fight, I would say. Yeah. Plus, it's out in the desert, and they didn't have too much space to black out, so therefore, we didn't lose too much money as far as theaters were concerned.
Yeah, I saw you that night.
Yeah, I was thinking about you, Johnny. I didn't want you to come like the last time, and the opponent sat down before you do. So, I made it my business to let this fight go some distance. But people are so funny. You understand?
Now a lot of people were against you for that. A lot of the sports writers, a lot of the press said they thought you were vindictive.
Shame.
They thought it was not right.
Shame.
That, you were doing this and that they thought it was an unfortunate thing.
What am I supposed to do? When I fought Sonny Liston, it was a hard 6 rounds. Not to say nothing bad about your son if you're out there watching. But both of Sonny's eyes were closed. He had stitches over both eyes. He was in bad shape. Broke his arm and almost. And then he sat down, because he had sense, he sat down in the sixth round. So the people said the champion gave up his title on the stool. It wasn't no good, it's a phony, and we're not coming to fight again. So I fought Sonny Liston the second time. He ran into a solid, hard, real right hand, Sport Illustrated told the people, they gave him the justice. They said it was a real punch. Marciano saw it, Patterson saw it. Later, the people finally came to the conclusion that it was a real punch. And Liston did too.
I saw the stop.
Then they say it's a fix. We want our money back. One fella say, I come from Sweden. One fella say, I come from China. I come from Germany. I come from here, everywhere. And the fight don't go a minute. So now, the second fight, the fight with Patterson. Mm-hmm. The fight goes 12 rounds. Oh, he could have killed him. He didn't do it. He could have knocked him out.